So that morning, I ran into one of my friend's moms. My friend plays for UCLA, and I was kind of talking back and forth with her, and essentially she kind of was telling me, like, how season was going to get canceled. Pac-12 was thinking about canceling their season. I know that the Ivies already had, so I kind of had an inkling that something was going to end, and I know that we stayed at a house with the boys, so the boys kind of had a talk that, like, their last match was most likely going to be the next day. But I assumed I had two matches, so I was like there was not a lot of pressure. It was just a matter of go out and have as much fun as you can. So I went out in doubles with Cam, did not play that well. Like, we kind of were just having fun out there, which obviously is, like, what you should do when you know it's going to be one of your last matches. And so I went into singles, like, pretty strong, won my first set pretty easily, lost my second set way faster than I could have imagined of, like, losing a set. So I was kind of in that break between second and third sets. And Paula just came up to me, and in my head, we're playing FDU later. So it's like, I can lose this. Like, I have another match. Like, it's just a matter of, like, going out and, like, making sure I have a good attitude. And Paula just came up to me and goes, "Hey, this is your last college match. So just go out and win it," and, like, walks off. And for me, like, it was kind of wild because, like, I didn't realize, like, what was going on, but, like, I kind of knew. So I ended up finishing that third set, crying my eyes out the entire time, which I do admit, playing tennis while crying is kind of hard, but I ended up winning it. So it was kind of, like, a nice moment. But I think that match, like, overall was just, like, kind of no pressure at all, but, like, kind of tense, since we were all kind of dealing with, like, we all wanted to play our best, but, like, we all knew it was, like, coming to the end of the season. So it was a lot of emotions going on. Like, tennis, you don't have a lot of breaks. So I think usually if you play a full third set, you get a full 10 minutes. But since we were playing a third set tiebreak, we only had, I think, like, 5 minutes. But I'm not the kind of person that likes to sit on court. Like, I hardly take water breaks, hardly anything. Like, I just, like, walk from one side of the court to the next. So for me, like, I actually, like, took my 5 minutes and was, like, sitting and thinking, like, oh my God, this is the last time I'm going to put Quinnipiac on. Like, this is the last time I'm going to go out and, like, represent my team. Like, I just wanted to make the best of it. And it was definitely hard. Like, we had one of the men traveled with us, and, like, he too was a senior. So, like, I assumed he probably knew, was on his phone, like, kind of looking stuff up. So, like, I'm looking for him. He looks tight right there. Like, I look at my, like, teammates. They're kind of, like, playing tight. I turned out, like, my coach, Paula, ended up telling everybody else, like, while they were playing the match. But she didn't want to tell me because it was a senior and it was my last match where, like, they kind of have other seasons to play. So it was definitely a weird moment. But, I don't know. At least I got to know that it was my last match and go out playing and fighting for it. I feel bad for everybody who didn't get to play their last match or it got canceled before. So, like, I don't know. A lot of people say, like, I couldn't imagine knowing while playing, but, like, I'm kind of glad that I knew it was my last match so I could put everything out there and just leave it on the court. But I think the environment at Quinnipiac is honestly one of the greatest environments. I talked to friends at other schools that have all gone across the country, and I'm so happy. Like, I couldn't have been treated better. Getting to know senior staff, getting to know coaches, getting to know other players, getting to get involved in the school. Like, and it's not just, like, obviously, like, athletics has done so much, but the school itself is, like, such a community that I feel like I've really been able to flourish. Like, I was that kid in high school that hardly showed up to class, like, never got involved in anything, like, woke up, went to school, went home, did my own thing, had my friends outside of, like, high school, like, kind of stayed away and separated that from my life. And I'm now coming out of college, like, Quinnipiac was my life for a while, like, and it still is. It's something that it's going to be there with me forever. So, like, I couldn't have made a better decision. Like, being able to get, like, the academics that I did, getting to play on a team of a competitive level, like, getting to be a part of SAC, getting to, like, travel with the school for business trips, like, it honestly, I couldn't have made a better decision. And I'm proud that even though it ended this way, like, it was the best decision I could have made. I feel like I've learned how to be a leader and how to care for other people more so. So I feel like the maturity and growing up is something that I really take away from Hamden. Like, being 3,000 miles away and learning how to do things on my own, like, it's something that you learn as a community with, like, Quinnipiac, which is something I don't necessarily know I would have done without having this taken for you.